Okay, guys, let's talk about arrays. Arrays are just a bunch of elements grouped together. So when you're creating an array in C sharp, you need to be precise what kind of stuff you are combining. For example, to create array with strings, you need to use string data type. Exactly same stuff as when you are creating variables, but here you need to use additional brackets. So that's like a theory. Let's create an array with programming languages. String and, as I said, this type of brackets. And of course we need to have some kind of container with name plugins. It's up to you what it will be. On the right side we will use curly brackets, and inside we will have double quotes because we are talking about strings, but many elements because these are elements. For example, Perl and favorite Python and Java and JavaScript and scary thing C++, and we're gonna finish with something very nice, C. Okay, so F5 to check that everything is fine. We will not see results, but we will be sure that there is no compilation errors. So that's cool. Okay, that worked. What about a combination of integers, array of integers? Well, again, integer, data type, and immediately this type of brackets, and then name for it, numbers. And in curly brackets, we're gonna use without quotes because we are talking about whole numbers. 1, 34, 25, something relatively big. And can we have duplicates? 56, 56, 56. And we're gonna finish with 100. Okay, F5 to check if everything is fine. No errors, but no usable results. So how we are going to use any of these automatically? How to print them? Well, we're learning another form of for loop, which is for each. For each is a time saver. How to start? Well, for each, this is concatenated, guys. And now inside of normal parentheses, you wanna have something that represents automatically any of these. So abstract representation. What that thing is, well, it's up to you. I'm gonna use, and a lot of people use E, and some people use X, Y, Z. It's totally up to you. Is that enough? Well, no. Here need to be a data type, and that data type must be same as this here. So string and right, but where those things are, because this is not enough. We need to target something. In this case we are targeting P language. So in P languages, and now we're gonna do some operation for simplicity reasons, so on. So console word italine, right line, that specific E, whatever it is in reality from P languages. Okay, save, and we will have bunch of these in order. Perl, Python, Java. Perl, Python, Java, JS, C++, C, JS, C++, C. Guys, absolutely same stuff with arrays with numbers. So, for order, EACH, concatenated, brackets, normal one, parentheses, and we're talking about integers here. So integer, so you can use E here or something else. I'm gonna use X to just make a difference, but you can use same stuff. In, where, in numbers. Numbers, and actually I'm gonna change this to S. So now grammatically everything is fine. And what else? Well, nothing pretty much, just the operation of printing. So I'm gonna steal this from here because I'm lazy, and we cannot use E here, we must use whatever it is here. So X, and now we will also have languages, and down there we're gonna have numbers. Can we have duplicates there? Well, there you go, 56, 56, 56. Question, because this is extremely easy. Can we do some kind of mathematical operations directly here? Well, actually, yes. You can say times, and we're gonna multiply that with, I don't know, with 3 for simplicity reasons, F5, and now we can check results. Okay, so first one is 1 times 3 3. 34 times 3, 102. So pretty much that's it. Final one, 100 times 3, 300. There you go. Okay, guys, honestly, there is nothing more to say in this tutorial. So as always, thank you for watching and see you in next one. Just remember, use data type, brackets, for each concatenated. Again, data type that needs to correspond to this thing, something abstract and target specific array. That's it. Thank you for watching. See you next one, definitely. Ciao.